Revelio.
Hey, for your information, I was just the other day. As for
Revelio.
It is well and bountiful.
Not a party to attend by myself. Revelio.
Back here.
Confringo!
Rest easy, my large friend.
About having a keen eye. Like me, for instance.
I rob every traveling vendor that passed through here. They never see it coming.
Was it upper or lower Hogsfield that we raided?
Shame nobody saw that.
Let me escape.
I need to race now, my friend.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
Looks interesting. Well, their goblin helm, but then it was ours. Arrest the momentum.
Easier to spot than in a rocket.
Surprised you're not fighting. expulsion!
Don't petrify us all, you know.
Accio, incendio. Incendio.
Expelliarmus. Hey, you're going to regret that. Fight! Rookwood, don't go down easy!
Wait till Sebastian hears about this. An Ashwinder. Revelio. Revelio. This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Thank you. Bombardier. Confringo. Imperial. Hitrificus Totalus.
Thinking in terms of good and evil merely indicates a limited imagination, in my opinion.
Revelio.
Come to think of it, months ago I had a brooch. Nice it was. Sparkled like the...
Shameful what you've done to helpless beasts.
Alohomora.
Thank you.
Incendio. Expelliarmus.
Finish.
Bombarda.
Nothing to poach an Arranger except spiders.
Revelio. Revelio.
You can feed a beast, or it can feed you. I prefer the latter.
Arrest him. Poaching days are over. Revelio. I should investigate. The course looks rather deserted. I hope everything's all right.
Ravenclaw, over here!
Hello again, Imelda. This course is a bit far from the castle, isn't it?
Obviously. Evidently too far for most of our classmates. Pathetic. They should be begging me to keep these trials alive, not running scared. I'm surprised our new fifth year showed up. I suppose I appreciate the effort.
That's actually... thank you.
I know I can be impatient, but I get frustrated by those who don't take things as seriously as I do. And in my experience, that's everyone. Anyway, don't let it go to your head. Right then, enough chatter. I'm confident I've posted a time you won't be able to beat.
Not just yet. Perhaps later. I'll come back when I'm feeling up to it.
No harm done. You take care of yourself.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
You're back! Nice to see you again. What are we looking for today? Thanks for stopping by. Hope to see you again.
Glad you came.
Over here.
This is a change of pace from our last outing.
Don't remind me. The thought of that tent still makes my blood boil. I've been thinking about those poor dragons in the fighting ring. The collars they were wearing, they appeared to be goblin silver. I think a collar is precisely what we found at that poacher camp. I've never known poachers to use anything like that before.
The dragon that attacked my carriage was wearing a collar, and Professor Fig was genuinely baffled by its behavior.
That attack always did strike me as a little strange, seemingly coming out of nowhere. Surely you aren't suggesting that the collars somehow control the poor creatures?
Exactly.
Merlin, I don't think the dragon we set free was wearing a collar, but we should check. And if we can find her, we can return her egg.
That's a good idea. We need to see this through.
I'll start looking into it right away. There was something else that I wanted to discuss with you. I didn't want to press it before. It seems I may have caused you more trouble with Victor Rookwood. Why is he after you?
Rookwood is working with Ranrok, and Ranrok is after something I found at Gringotts. Fig had a portkey that led us there after the dragon attack. It's a bit of a long story, and Fig had asked that I not speak of it yet.
Goodness. Well, that certainly helps to shed light on what we saw at the tent. Don't worry, I'll guard your secret as if it were my own. I shan't press for more details. In fact, I should probably be going. I'd like to track that dragon down as soon as I can. I'll let you know when I have news of her location.
Oh, I do hope Mary and her neighbours aren't harmed.
Excuse me, sir. Are you all right?
Just barely. But I don't want to trouble a student with my woes.
I am indeed a student, but I could very well be able to help you.
I'm not so sure. Name's Crispin Dunn, by the way. I trade in the surrounding hamlets. Do the most business in Arranshire. A lovely little hamlet, just stunning gardens. Just the other day, the Daily Prophet ran an article on its scenic hedgerows. Actually, before I go on, I should ask, are you afraid of spiders?
Spiders don't bother me at all. You'd be impressed by how many I've dispatched lately.
Lucky you. The hamlet's overrun with the vile things, and they're acting abnormally aggressively. I'm concerned about my customers, of course, but it appears that most of the hamlet's residents fled to safety. It's my friend Mary I worry about. I haven't heard from her, and I fear she's trapped in her cottage.
Understandable, but why don't you check on her yourself?
I would, but I have a crippling fear of the eight-legged beasts, which I, unlike you, seem incapable of conquering. I don't know what to do. Can you think of anyone who can help Mary?
Why are there so many spiders in Arranshire all of a sudden?
I honestly don't know. I've never seen so many spiders in all of my life. It's almost as if someone's breeding them. They've trapped the entire hamlet in webs. I was lucky to escape it all. Mary always has a way with these beasts. It's very concerning not to hear from her.
Why is it you can't conquer your fear of spiders?
When I was a small child, I was being tormented and chased by a group of local bullies and slid into the hollow of a tree to hide. Within moments, spiders were crawling over every inch of my body. Seemed I'd stumbled on a nest. I couldn't move, paralyzed by fear of the spiders and an equally profound fear of the wizards I knew were just outside the tree. I was there for what seemed hours. I can feel their legs on me now just talking about it. Ugh.
Why didn't you ask the ministry for help?
I did. Reached out to anyone who would listen. Tried Minister Spout Old Spavin himself. But evidently they have their hands full with who knows what else. It seems this little hamlet has to fend for itself.
I'll try my very best, Mr. Dunn.
Please do. If you can think of anyone that may be brave enough to help, I'd appreciate it. Thank you. They'll find Arranshire southeast of Hogsmeade, just below the train station.
Revelio. This must be Arranshire. I'd best keep an eye out for spiders.
Aqua!
Surely that's the last of them. Revelio. Alohomora. Mind now, demiguys. Revelio. Oh no, this must be Mary. Poor woman. If Mary was breeding these things in her cellar, that means there are more underground. I'll need to destroy every last spider in that cellar if this is to end. Revelio. Revelio. If this is where Mary bred the spiders, they're not here now. Well, this isn't a good sign. These spiders have gone somewhere. A ladder. Not sure I want to know where this leads. I'd best be ready for whatever I may find down there. Revelio. Egg sacs. I need to find and destroy all of these before the situation gets even worse.
About the location of our Hebridean dragon friend and where to return her if you know where. Meet me in the town circle of Hogsmeade.
Incendio! Expelliarmus! Defender! Revelio! but I need to destroy all of the exacts. Rebellion. Rebellion. Last of the spider sacks. I suppose I know what happened to Mary Portman now. She was breeding the spiders. Revelio. Oh, wait. That's the last one. She's angry. Revelio. Revelio. Sometimes it seems all roads lead.
Revelio.
Glad you came.
I wish I had the courage to go into the forest.
Mr. Dunn, I have some news.
Thank Merlin. About my sweet friend Mary.
It seems poor Mary was breeding spiders in her home for profit, and vastly underestimated their propensity to multiply.
Oh, Mary, what untoward scheme were you involved in? If she needed financial assistance, she could have just come to me. She didn't deserve this. Few do.
I am sorry about your friend, but you'll be relieved to know that I cleared out the spiders. It's safe to return now.
You? You cleared out the spiders? I can't believe it, but I'm certainly relieved.
I imagine the first order of business will be to help the amulet rebuild. I suppose I have nothing to fear from dead spiders.
That's the spirit. I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you again for all you've done. I shall keep you apprised.